As an example of all the machinery of curvature and tangent vectors and principal normal vectors and binormal vectors and all the rest, we're going to work out essentially all of the quantities of interest for a helix. Now, a helix is given by a curve a cosine of ti plus a sine of tj plus btk. So in other words, if you project it onto the xy plane, it's just going around in a circle of radius a. But at the same time, it's going upwards at a rate b. So if b is moderately large, you get a picture like this. If b is small, you get a picture more like this. So b is essentially how much you've stretched out your spring or your slinky. Okay, and we're going to figure out the velocity. We're going to figure out the acceleration. We're going to figure out the tangent vector and the normal vector. We're going to work out the curvature, and we're going to work out the arc length. So let's start with the velocity. For the velocity, we want to take the derivative of the position. Okay, well, that's easy. The derivative of a cosine t is minus a sine t. Derivative of a sine t is a cosine. Derivative of bt is b. Great. So then we want to figure out what is our speed. Well, the speed is just the size of the velocity. So you take the square root of this squared plus this squared plus this squared, a squared sine squared t, a squared cosine squared t, together these add up to a squared plus b squared. So that gives us the square root of a squared plus b squared. Not too surprisingly, as you keep going around in the circle and drifting upwards, you're always moving at the exact same speed. And that speed has a horizontal part and a vertical part. Okay, then we want to know the arc length. Well, the arc length is just the integral of the speed. So we integrate the speed, and we just get our speed times time plus a constant. Simple enough. The next thing we want to figure out is our tangent vector. So to get our tangent vector, we take our velocity and divide by our speed. So we want a unit vector pointing in the direction of our velocity. Now remember, our velocity is this vector, and its length is root a squared plus b squared. So we just divide things out. And here it is in IJK notation. You see, this is our velocity vector. And then we divide by root a squared plus b squared. Or in our angle bracket notation, well, here's our velocity divided by the speed. The next thing we want is, now that we've got our tangent vector, we want to figure out our normal vector. And the normal vector is the direction that the tangent vector is changing. So we take the derivative of the tangent vector, and derivative a sine is a cosine. Derivative a cosine is negative a sine. And if you want the unit vector, if you just divide this by its length, all you're left with is the minus cosine minus sine 0. So going back to our original picture, our tangent vector at any given time is a little bit side, is going around the circle, but is also tilting up. Our normal vector is just pointing straight in towards the axis. And I can't draw, but these are supposed to be perpendicular. Okay, so now we got our tangent vector, we got our normal vector, and the next thing we want to look at is acceleration. Well, acceleration is one of the easiest things to compute, because you just take the derivative of the velocity. We had our velocity, take its derivative, and you just get minus a cosine t minus a sine t. And you notice that the velocity is pointing in the exact same direction as the normal vector. It's a times the normal vector. Now that's a little weird, because usually The acceleration has two components. It has a forward and back component that has to do with how much you're changing speed. Then it has a sideways component that has to do with how much you're changing direction. But in this case, our speed was a constant. Our speed was always root a squared plus b squared. So we're never accelerating forwards, we're never accelerating backwards. All of our acceleration is in the sideways direction. So if you want to break up the acceleration into a tangential and normal piece, it's all normal. Okay, then let's work out the curvature. The curvature is the rate at which the tangent vector is changing with respect to arc length. And that's the rate at which it's changing with respect to time divided by the speed. The rate at which it's changing with respect to time, well, we worked out the rate at which it's changing with respect to time. And the length of that guy is a over root a squared plus b squared. And the speed is root a squared plus b squared. So the ratio is a over a squared plus b squared. And the radius of curvature is 1 over that. So it's a squared plus b squared over a. Now, you'll notice that here, I claim this is the curvature times the velocity squared times the normal vector. Because the curvature is a over a squared plus b squared. The velocity is root a squared plus b squared. Sorry, the speed is root a squared plus b squared squared. These cancel, and you just get a times n. Another way to write this is that it's the speed squared divided by the radius of curvature times the normal. That's always the normal component of your acceleration. It's always v squared over r, where r is the reciprocal of the curvature, is a squared plus b squared over a. Okay. Last thing, there's another useful formula for getting curvature, which involves a cross product. You take the cross product of the velocity and the acceleration and divide by the speed cubed. And if you work that out, the cross product of the velocity and the acceleration gives you a few terms. You work that out. You take the length of that. You divide by the speed cubed. And you get the exact same answer as you did before. So you can either use this formula for the curvature, or you can use the notion that curvature is the rate at which the tangent vector is changing, and they'll give you the same answer.